Welcome dear students. In this video I am going to explain the experiments. So let us first see while doing experiment what we have to take care. First we write aim. Aim or objective means what we are going to do. Like in today's experiment I am going to determine the density of a glass. So today we will determine the density of a glass. This is the today's aim or objective of the experiment. Next we will see what are the apparatus required. To find the density of a glass we require a glass slab whose density we have to find. We need a scale to measure the length, breadth and height of the glass slab and a electronic balance to measure its mass. Now the next point we will see, what is the theory? So as we know, density is equals to mass by volume. Mass by volume. So first students, we will calculate the mass of the glass slab and then we will determine the volume of the glass slab. After finding these two, we will divide mass by volume and we will get the density. Next term is procedure. Procedure means how we are finding the mass and volume. That is called the procedure. Observations, the length, we will take the mean length, we will determine the length 2-3 times and we will take the average or mean of that length. Similarly, breadth also we will calculate 2-3 times and average we will take. So that is our observations. Calculation, we will find that divide mass by volume, that is calculation. And finally, we will write the result. Certain precautions also we have to see, such that when we are measuring the length, we should use our scale, proper scale, and we should start from the zero of this scale. So let us start our experiment. First, we will determine the volume. So for finding the volume, we will first find out its length. To find out its length, we will use our scale and from the zero of the scale, we will measure its length. So as you can see, it is 10.1 centimeter. So we can write the length is 10.1 centimeter. Similarly, we will calculate this length 2-3 times and the average of that will be the length of the glass slab. So I said we will calculate length and as I got it the length, that is 10.2 centimeter. So I have written it by calculating once only, but we have to calculate at least 5 times and we will take the average of that. The another way, we can use a scale or we can use a pen or pencil and we can draw its outline. After drawing the outline of this glass slab, also we can measure the length. So we can determine its length by drawing the outline. So first we will take the outline of this glass slab. And then also, so as I have taken the outline and we can measure this length also. So this will be also the length of the glass slab. Similarly, we can measure the breadth. Breadth we can measure, that is 6 point. So we can see from 0, we will start from 0, not from this point. We will start from the 0. So from 0 to this, so we can see 6.3. So similarly, we will calculate 2-3 times this breadth also. So breadth I have written 6.3 centimeter. Now to find the its height, again we can take the height is this one. So we can keep the glass slab in this way, and again we can draw its outline in this manner, and we can measure this distance. So we can measure this distance, and this will be the height, that is 1.9. So this also we will do 2-3 times, and then after we will write. So height is 1.9 centimeter. Now children, as I said, I have calculated once only, but we have to take 2-3 times, and then we will take the average. So volume we can calculate. As you know, the volume is equals to length into breadth into height. So we can substitute these values, that is 10.2 into 6.3 into 1.9. After multiplying, we will get the volume in centimeter cube. And we can calculate the mass of the glass slab using our electronic balance. So let it be a start. After then, we will just use this to open it, and we will keep it inside this, and we will measure the mass. So as we can see, the mass, it seems 302.22. So we can write the mass is equals to 302.22 gram. So after getting volume and mass, we can determine the density. The density what we will get, that is in, it is mass is measured in gram and volume is measured in centimeter. So gram by centimeter cube. So we can get it in gram per centimeter cube, and then after by multiplying it with, suppose we are getting x, then we will multiply it by 1000, and we will get it in SI unit, that is kg per meter cube. So in this way we can determine the density of a glass slab. So this is all about the finding the density of glass slab. Thank you students, thank you for watching.